This is a dumb air purifier, and today we're gonna make a brain implant and make it smart by using this, a two-channel Zigbee switch. This is the little brain that we'll be using today in our project. It comes in multiple versions, 1, 2, or 4 outputs. This version, it's a two-channel, so it has 2 relay outputs. These are dry contacts that can be connected in either normal open or normal closed operations. And on the other side, I choose the model that can be powered directly to AC 250 volts. By surprise, I also have a micro USB port over here. I can actually use it and I can power the device via 5 volt if I want. It is a Zigbee device. Here we have a few buttons. We have manual operations for relay 1 or relay 2, and this is labeled mode switch. Mode switch allows us to switch how those relays work. You can switch it from normal operation to toggle. Normal operation will mean that on a button push or on a command send, the relay will stay on or off depending on what command we send. If we choose the toggle mode, it will switch on for half a second and then back off. I think it's even less, it's around 200 milliseconds, more or less. The air purifier has multiple buttons, but in my case, I only care about these two: humidifier on or off and power on or off. The timer settings on the unit are not so interesting, since I can use Home Assistant to tell it to turn the unit off or the humidifier off after a certain period of time. And these two dry contact relay, it's perfect for the job. Let's take the air purifier apart and see what we can do. We have 2 screws on the sides. And now this cover should lift off. Here we have a few connectors that we need to take out, 2 screws, another cable that should just pull off, a connector on the side, and this is what we are working on. I see there's an empty space, so with a little bit of luck, we'll be able to put our Zigbee switch right inside here, so it will be totally hidden. This is the board that we just took out of the air purifier. As you can see, the buttons that we need to use are these ones on the right side. They're just simple buttons with 2 connectors. On the back, we can see the soldering point for this on the board. We're lucky that this board is very simple. You can actually see everything over here. I have prepared 2 pairs of wires. They're a little bit too thick, but I don't think that's gonna be an issue. All we have to do now is solder it on the back of this button. Let's get started. I'm gonna flip it around. The first pair of points are these ones over here, and the second button should be on these points over here. For the start, let's use brown and white wires. These are the first 2 points that we're gonna connect to. Now for the second set, we are going to use yellow and green. Okay, all seems right. Let's test them out. Perfect. Now white and brown. I know I don't have the best soldering skills, but anyway, this one is also working. In order to connect them to the module, we have to connect this wire to the common and normal open contacts on both of the 2 relays. We have white and brown. Then we're gonna have green and yellow. With everything in place, we can take the cap and clip it on. You can see that it has a system here that will press on the wire and will not let them slip. Make sure everything is nicely arranged. And it's done. The only thing left is on the left side over here, we need to provide either 250 volts AC or power via micro USB. This is how it looks with everything wired back in. I have provided 240 volts power from the side over there. Now we can close back everything and add it to Home Assistant. If we go to Zigbee to MQTT, in devices you can see that I already added the switch over here. It is a router type and it exposes, you don't have too much information except the state of the two relays. If we go back to the dashboard, you can see the Daikin brain added, and I renamed the two relays as air purifier and humidifier. Since they're set on toggle, each time I want to turn on the purifier, it will just click and go back, but it actually gets the job done. Probably there is a way to adjust these toggles to stay on or off visually, even if they're just switching on and off in the background, but I didn't research that part for the moment. You now have a smart appliance, even if from the factory it was a little bit dumb. Now for the fun of it, let's make a small test. Siri, turn on air purifier. Siri, turn on humidifier. As you can see, it works quite nicely. Of course, there are some adjustments that need to be made within Home Assistant, but overall, this is quite a nice solution and also not expensive. That's it for this video. If you found it useful, please don't forget to like and subscribe.